We've reached the 2-minute warning, and this thing has been one-sided, and they hope to at least have something to feel good about going into halftime. They've put this ball on lockdown. 8th play of the drive coming up. Keep it on the ground. Solid fundamentals on that tackle from this freshman.
And the running back didn't get much there. Nice job by the defense. You can tell they're focused in on this running back, on this run game, being physical, getting knockbacks, and limiting his carries.
Looking to throw on third. Makes the grab. It's Hendricks. He's brought down, but he's got him inside the 10. First and goal from the 8. On the doorstep of cashing it in for the offense. Keeping it on the ground on first and goal. Couple of guys there to get him on the ground. Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. He's looking to throw. Getting some heat. And here's a fumble way behind the line. Defense just cradling that fumble and securing it. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own. Central Michigan has it back. Let's see what the Chippewas can do on offense. He's brought down quickly. Minimal gain there. Still a bit short of the first down. The offense quickly calls timeout to stop the clock. Now on second down. Back to throw. It's Lavis. Flips it out to the back. And a good job in coverage there as they stop it after just a few.
This defense is going to have to be careful. Not only do they have to worry about this guy running the football, but they've got to keep their eye on him when he runs routes, too. He is a versatile back.
Got the back over the middle. And the catch was one thing, and the run even better. A big pickup on that one. That's going to wrap up the first half here, and now we join Kevin with a halftime update. The Chippewas will kick it off to start the second half. He'll start the return inside his 5. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Ohio takes over. The Bobcat offense heads to the field. Those 2 first-half turnovers really damaging, and the primary reason they find themselves trailing to start the 3rd quarter.
And this is an offense that prides themselves on taking care of the football and then having explosive plays. You know they're playing angry right now. They're mad. They know they're the reason why they're down in this game, so I expect them to come out here lighting it up here if the first drive at the second half.
Yeah, and this defense playing fast, playing physical, forcing things into action, forcing those turnovers. They played really well in this first half.
He wants to pass it on second down. That's caught. It's Harris. He's brought down. Solid pickup, but a little bit short of the first down.
And I love when my quarterback sees zone and knows exactly where to go with the football, sees the wide receiver running the drag route, knows when to throw it, pulls the trigger for the easy completion.
They'll try to get it through the air. And they get the sack right out of the gate. And the Bobcats will bring the punt team onto the field. The punter going to get his first work of the afternoon. Oh, he got home and blocked the punt.
And every week you study this and you know which side you're going to attack and who you want to attack. And you could tell they wanted to attack the right side. Brought all the guys from that direction. Sneak through a little crack. Come in, get their hands on the punt, and get the big block.
Touchdown, Chips. They want to finish the season strong, and man, are they doing that here this Week 11 performance. The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. Well, just as you would expect, that didn't take very long.
It didn't, Reese, and you've got to make great field position count. When you've got opportunities, you got to pay it off. And the offense took advantage, scoring a touchdown. Didn't have far to go, but they got the points they needed.
Ohio U ready to go back to work on offense. He wants to throw. Trailing now by 17, David, this is an opportunity that they need to answer.
And down by 17, it's not panic mode yet. Like, I know we just gave up some points and our defense hasn't played great. I think this offense can still be who they are and stay consistent.
No doubt, lots of football to go, but you do get the feeling this is the time of game where...
Going up top. And that's going to be incomplete, going for broke on second down, but third down's coming up.
Well, at this juncture in the game, with how the scoreboard looks, no question this offense is going to have to throw to get back in the game. And it's going to be tricky now because the defense is expecting it. You're going to throw into a lot of big zone coverages with everybody's eyes on the quarterback. Not going to be easy.
He finds his man, and he's got enough for the first down. It'll be at the 35.
You got to give the O-line a lot of credit there because it gave the receiver time to work all the way across the field on the drag route against zone coverage. Quarterback gets it to him. He's able to turn it up and get a first down.
And the defense snows him under after a very short game.
And these defensive tackles just eat people. They swallow human beings when you get near them. They're so big, so strong. Those guys, those running backs coming, they just need a mitt. They put one mitt on a running back, and he usually falls to the ground just because of their sheer mass and strength.
And I think the quarterback throwing that pass off his back foot is what led to that incompletion. Just not as accurate as he would have liked to have been.
On third down, he'll try to pick it up through the air. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down.
Well, after struggling so much in the first half, you thought they would have made some adjustments here at halftime to see if they can open up this passing game. But early on in the second half, you're just not really able to get that done. Incompletion on third down in your own end, you're expecting them to punt.
A famous writer once said, most men lead lives of quiet desperation. Here is a desperate move, going for it on fourth down, trailing by double figures. Finds his man, they convert. The expressway is wide open. And they finally get him to the ground. An easy conversion for this offense. Defense, not exactly the perfect fourth down call here. The big explosive play put him right on the edge, but you've got to finish the deal. And the defense sold out to stop the run, and they do here on first down.
Man, not much wiggle room for the ball carrier there.
Not really sure what they can do to try to create some space.
I know. Block better. How about the offensive lineman push some guy backwards and make some holes?
They'll try it again from the one on second and goal. Tries again to get it in. Going right back to the well, and this time he finds water. Gets it into the end zone for the touchdown. And the extra point is good, but they're still down 24-14. So it's an 80-yard drive, and they capped it off with a one-yard punt. And no chance at a return here. They'll start this drive at their own 25. Central Michigan takes over, and we'll get another look at this offense. After standing on the sideline and watching that long touchdown drive, they really need to put something together to give their defense a rest.
And that's a real thing, man. Like, you've played a lot of plays. You get worn out. You need a chance to go decompress on the sideline, get some oxygen. Palmer, now it's on this offense.
Yeah, this is the definition of complementary football because it's a two-pronged problem. You've got to score points and answer, but you've also got to take your time and give your defense an opportunity to get their win.
They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Man, oh, man, am I upset at my offensive line to give up penetration that fast? Man, we blinked and missed it.
Hey, he barely got the ball and just got destroyed immediately. What a great play. They'll try to drive ahead on third and short. Still on his feet at the 45. And he'll ramble to the 34 before he's finally knocked down.
Third down and two. You know it's time to get physical, and this unit paves the way, Jesse, and gets the big first down.
And this back's got such a burst, too, doesn't he? As soon as he saw the hole, he exploded through it and picked up a huge chunk of yards.
Squeezes out a couple of yards down to the 32. Okay, Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. Going to the running game. And he found plenty of running room on that one before the defense was finally able to get him down.
I tell you what, with this kind of success on the ground, I think you two knuckleheads could call plays. I mean, that's how easy it is for this offense right now. They got the ground game working. It's really easy. Now you can open up for other things, but you guys could even try your hand because they're dominating right now.
Running behind those pads, he gets a couple before he stopped at the 18. Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. After run, now throw. Makes the catch. It's Lewis. And he'll step across the sidelines after making a good gain on that one. Boy, they love to move the sticks here and take a shot at it on first and goal. Snap from the gun on third down. He's got it on the move. Gets it inside the 5, down to the 4, and it'll be first and goal. Defense is backed up. Shadow of the goalpost trying to defend their own end zone. Turning to the running game on first and goal. He steps and powers and works his way. They finally get him down at the 2. Now it's second and goal. Tries again to get it in. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
And with the stuff there, Jesse, on second down, this little third to mid-range, you got 2 downs. What are you thinking here?
Maybe getting your quarterback out on the perimeter and giving him a run-pass option. See if you can get the defense in a bind.
How good have they been on third down today? And another opportunity here on third and goal. Pocket starts to collapse. And he just throws it away on third down. And I don't think you can give up on a play like that. They'll send out the kicker here. He was on target with his first kick, and this one ought to be easy from 20 yards away. That is no good. Guys, a double-digit lead is good, but more would have been better.
That's just a chip shot. That's just a field goal.
Returns to the field. There's certainly still a hill to climb, but they've got to make sure these drives pay off. Got a touchdown last time. Can they back it up here?
Well, and it's amazing in a football game how sometimes they'll surprise you with what you do. Once you get settled and you realize what's going on, now I'm comfortable with it. Jesse, this offense looked comfortable on its last drive.
They sure did. It looked like they started to find some momentum. So now it's on this defense to stop that, all right?
He tosses one high and deep down the left side. And the incomplete pass, taking a shot on second down, and they'll be left with a third down.
Yeah, and I like like the shot, the aggressive play down the field. And we like throwing those jump balls up to my receiver because usually the receiver makes the play and makes the defender look bad. Nice job by the defender getting a hand on it, tipping that ball away from the wide receiver.
Another incompletion on third down.
It's so nice when you know it's third and long, you know a pass is coming, you worked on it all week, get your feet set at the sticks, understand that quarterback's got to be rushed, get him off of this spot. Nice execution by this defense.
And they'll down this just inside the 35-yard line. Central Michigan has it back. Let's see what the Chippewas can do on offense. You want to talk about taking the wind out of your sails. Drive the ball down the field and miss the field goal, David.
You know what? Don't leave it up to kickers. Execute better offensively. I think you move the ball nice. You got to keep that in mind. But Palmer, I think you got to stay aggressive and don't settle for field goals.
Yeah, because you got to know there's just no margin for error right now. You just have got to be able to execute at a high level.
To the air. It's Labus. They're trying to get to it. And he can't escape, and down he goes.
This defense, they are tenacious, and they've got guys up front that are athletic, and they are so strong that they can collapse the pocket. You saw it right there in that play action.
They try to pop a run on the draw, and he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down, and the Chippewas will try to pin them back with the punt. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. They'll get down and put a stop to this return. They'll mark it at the 32. Ohio takes over. The Bobcat offense heads to the field. Boy, three and out last time, Davey. They'd like to be more productive this time around.
Yeah, in the last drive, nothing really clicked. No rhythm. Got off the field really, really quickly. They need to put something together.
Oh, he's going to try to hit him over the top. Fires into traffic and intercepted. He'll try to take it back. And they'll close in on him after a good return on the interception.
QB never saw the defender. He's staring his receiver down, telegraphing his throw, and the DB jumped all over that.
They'll run it. Just a solid stop by this sophomore. As they get set to snap it, time winding down here in the quarter. He's looking for an open man on second down. Got the quick pass. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down. We've come to the end of the quarter, guys, and Central Michigan has the lead. Let's take a quick look at the national rankings to see how this playoff race is shaping up. It's first and 10 from the 31. Looking to move it through the air. Fires to the big fella. There to make the tackle, but the big throw is good enough to give them a first down.
I love an offense that wants to stay aggressive. Even when you've got the lead late in a game like this, right, you still try to find your playmakers and get them the ball in space, and that is exactly what this offense is doing.
He's got it on the run, and he cruises his way to the house. Touchdown, Chippewas! Boy, do they need that score. Gave them a little cushion as they try to put a stop to this two-game slide.
There's no mercy rule in college football, man. They've got a huge lead here in the fourth quarter. They are still chucking it, and they are still scoring.
Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And as the ball makes its way into the end zone, it'll be a touchback. They'll bring it out to the 25. Ohio U ready to go back to work on offense. Well, the good news about this drive, Jesse, it can't go worse than last time through a pick on the first play. He's taking the shot. Toast the coverage, got it deep downfield.
What a beautiful throw and catch on this play, and I love the job the receiver did tracking the ball in the air. Nice job of locating the throw and then hauling it in.
Fires to the wideout. He caught it. They'll get him stopped just short of the end zone, but they're in business here with the first down. The offense threatening, close to the end zone now with a new set of downs. And he takes it to the house. Touchdown, Bobcats.
This is a guy that put a lot of pressure on himself coming into the season. He felt like he was ready to have a breakout year. He knew he had all the tools in the toolbox to be able to get it done, and he's showing it. That's his 10th rushing touchdown on the season.
takes this from inside the five. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Central Michigan takes over, and we'll get another look at this offense. They're going to throw it to start the drive. Just a little off. Incomplete. Line getting set on second down. They'll throw again after the incompletion. Just a short pass to the tight end. And he'll make his way out of bounds after the solid pickup.
Nice catch by the big target. Those big tight ends, you can tell in football, are just becoming more and more of a weapon in every single team.
Back to throw, it's Lavis. And a missed opportunity on third down as the defense knocks it free, and fourth down is coming up. The Chippewas send out the punt unit. Waves the arm for the fair catch, and the catch is made close to the 30-yard line. The Ohio U offense returns to the field. Okay, right. Looking for a productive play on first down. Trying to start the drive with a pass. Throwing right. He's got it. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down. Receivers work tirelessly, tapping that toe along the sideline, and it just looks so natural for him.
Yeah, it can't just be pat and go all the time, right? Reese just jogging down the field, ball hits you right in stride. You got to be able to make awkward body catches and do it.
And he throws his third pick of the day. His head has to be spinning. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own. On first down, here comes this offense. Here we go. He's looking to throw it. Quick completion on the out route. And he's able to bounce off one tackle for a solid pickup. That completion leaves us with second and medium. He's looking to throw. Got it in the middle. It's Davis. They make the stop, but there is a flag on the field. We'll see what that's all about.
Open.
Just an obvious holding call there, and one that just kills an offense's momentum. They'll line up for a second down play. Looking downfield, it's Lavis. Receiver looks it in, it's complete. They stop him almost immediately. Short gain there, still a little ground covered. Pick up the first. Ball is at the 41 as his defense tries to force the punt on third and long. Throws to the wideout. And they can't hook up on the big play, and that brings up a fourth down. And the Chippewas line up to punt it away. Fourth time tonight we've seen this guy come on to punt. No return coming. He'll call for the fair catch. Ohio takes over. The Bobcat offense heads to the field. After throwing the pick on the last drive, need to take care of the ball this time, Jesse.
We're going to find out.
He's going to let one fly down the middle. And they can't make the connection, going for a big play on first down. It's great for this quarterback to take shots down the field, but you just don't want it to feel like a give-up or a chuck-it-up-and-hope kind of play.
And I think understanding the situation, now I'm on defense, right? If they're going to take shots down the field, maybe I'm a little bit more aggressive with my blitz, understanding that everything's going to take a little bit more time to develop if they're going to take those deep shots.
This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. From the gun, wants to pass. Fires left. It's caught. They stay aggressive and push their way out to the 33, and it's first down.
Well, down two possessions. Good news is you get the completion. Bad news, though, did not get out of bounds. You know right now, saving the clock, that is at a premium for this offense.
And that incomplete pass caused by the big hit on first down. Second down coming. Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. On second down, they'll take to the air. Right down the middle. And it'll be incomplete. This is some physical pass defense. They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. On third and long, he has to throw for it. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down.
And now such a tough situation. Late in this game, you're trailing, but now it's fourth and long. Like, it's one thing if it's fourth and short. This makes it even more difficult. You got to have something dialed up you feel really great about.
Down in the fourth quarter, it's too late for empty possessions. They'll go for it on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Makes the grab well past the sticks. And they finally make the tackle, but this will be a pretty easy conversion for this offense. The Bobcats are on the move. He'll just keep slinging it. Drops the football. He had him right down the gut of the field. Instead, it'll be second down. Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. On second down, he'll let it fly. Fires to the middle. What a job to lay out and make the catch. Got open on the post and then had no regard for his body in making that catch.
Exactly right. You know you're going to get hit a lot of times coming over the middle of the field, but he runs that post, lays out, makes the play for his quarterback. That's a tough hombre.
Get set. He'll come out throwing on first down. Just flying through the air like a superhero to make the grab. First and goal, and this feels like their chance to make a game of it. He wants to throw it. For six. Another interception. This guy just can't find his own players. And after the interception and the turnover, this defense has set its offense up for business. They're backed up. First and 10 from inside their own five. Let's see if they can create some space. That hole closed quickly. He'll get one out to the six.
Well, they've got the lead. The defense just did their part, getting a takeaway. So now if you're on offense, you want to run the ball and take as much time as possible between snaps. Stay in bounds and let this clock tick away.
That'll be a beneficial run as he creates some breathing room and gets it up to the 13-yard line. Referee signals timeout. It's the defense wanting to make sure that they have everything just right with a big play coming. Crosses the 30, he's got a lane. And he's brought down at the 40-yard line, and that'll be a first down. The Chippewas moving quickly to the line.
Yeah, it's make or break time for this defense. Now, they got to get a stop, and if that's bringing more bodies in, bringing more beef in, they're running the football right up the gut, right at you. They're not going to throw the football in this situation. Time to be more physical and get this big stop.
We've reached the two-minute warning, and this offense is that much closer to salting away a victory. And the Chippewas have it with a first and 10. They want that clock to run. Turns it on in midfield. And he's brought down after a nice game. Quick timeout called by the defense. Stop. Save as much time as possible for their offense. Line gets set, first down. The quarterback takes a snap and takes a knee. It has been said that the obstacle is the way, and this obstacle is now back-to-back losses.